Hello, and welcome to Songs for the Struggling Artist, the blogcast. This is episode 284. My name is Emily Rainbow Davis, and this is the last blogcast of the year, of 2021. 2021 has been such a great, good time year, hasn't it? I know it actually has been for some people. I don't know any of those people, but I know they exist. I am not holding any hopes for 2022 because at the end of 2020, I thought, oh, great, we'll get a new year and this one will be better. And I can't say it has been. This is actually a good preview for what this blog is going to be. This isn't my most cheerful work. This is a piece that I had to write down just because I was trying to sort it out, and I wasn't 100% sure it would even turn into a public expression of what was going on. I wrote it at the beginning of this winter, and winter has already come to get us, so we're deep in it now. But this is not a cheerful one. If you want to skip this, feel free. Yeah, there's plenty of cheerful ones right before this, I think, or right after. I don't know. You'll find some. There are a few lighthearted ones in the mix in the last chunk of time, and those may be more your speed. And I support you listening to whatever feels right at the moment. This one isn't like super sad or super depressing or whatever. It's just like me dealing with winter. It doesn't need any trigger warnings, I don't think, unless you have like a response to tentacles, because those will show up. So if tentacles freak you out, also skip this one. But hopefully it's not like, you know, I don't know. I've warned you. There's not much to warn you about. I just know sometimes, I don't know, I think we're all in a kind of extra sensitive space at the moment as Omicron just, you know, barrels down on us. So here, let me just read it to you instead of telling you about it. Here, it is called Now is the Winter of My Discontent. The temperature has dropped. I pulled my winter coat out of the closet. Our third pandemic winter has begun. Last year, I sat writing under the heat lamps outside at the toast and roast, grateful not to have to be at my kitchen table to write, but dreaming of the day we'd get the vaccine and I could safely sit inside a cafe again. And here I am. Back outside at the Toast and Roast, the only coffee place with heat lamps in my neighborhood. Despite the fact that I have been vaccinated and have been so since I last sat here in the spring. Could I go inside somewhere? Sure. Despite the fact that sitting indoors to eat or drink is one of the riskiest things we can do, I'm sure I will at some point. But despite the fact that proof of vaccination is required to sit inside cafes here in New York City, very few places here have been diligent about asking, which does not give me great confidence about the vaccination status of those indoors, especially given the signs on some windows proclaiming they don't discriminate against unvaccinated people. I mean, at least those signs make it clear where I definitely will not be going. The me who sat at this toast and roast table a year ago would be shocked to learn that so many people have been resistant to getting the vaccine. Didn't we all go through this nightmare together? Did they not hear the ambulances screaming through the night? Did they not walk past the morgue trucks? Did they not sit feeling trapped inside their apartments, afraid of any passing contact that could be dangerous with a loved one or stranger? When I last sat here at Toast and Roast, under the heat lamp, I would have chewed off my own arm to get a vaccine. But the thing of it is, it doesn't matter all that much that I, as an individual, have the vaccine if the community around me is not fully vaccinated. Like, sure, when a mass shooter decides to start spraying bullets, it's good to have a bulletproof vest on. But it won't save your neighbors, and you could still catch a bullet. Better to not have a shooter, number one, but barring that, it's better if shields can be up for the whole community. And yes, this is a very American analogy, isn't it? I cannot understand why someone who can get the vaccine would not. I start to wonder if maybe the pandemic just hasn't been so bad for some folks. Like, maybe they just love Zoom and they want to stay on it forever. Not only would I have chewed off my own arm to get a vaccine, I'd have welcomed almost any side effect. Like, oh, we're going to get you vaccinated, but you're going to grow a tentacle. Fine, I'd like to introduce you to my new tentacle. It's very useful in slippery situations. And if we all grew tentacles when we were vaccinated, great. At least I'd be able to tell who the hell was vaccinated so I'd know if I could sit inside with them or not. I'd hang out indoors at the Tentacle Cafe without a care in the world. I'd never have to go to Toast and Roast again. Sorry, Toast and Roast guys, I love you, but your bagel shop cafe has now become a symbol of my winter sadness, so it's hard for me to keep going. At this point, I would welcome a tentacle if it meant I could safely sit in a cafe or a theater or a concert hall and know for sure that everyone is vaccinated and that breakout infections would be rare. It would make buying clothes really tricky, but you know, I can sew and I've learned a few new tricks while sitting in my apartment for nearly 2 years, so give me a tentacle! As this third pandemic winter bears down upon me, I'm not sure I can take winter's punishments, but I could handle a tentacle. All around me, things are returning to normal. People are pretending everything's okay when over 1,000 people, on average, are still dying every day in this country, and even the normal is not normal. I saw a video of a final dress rehearsal of a college production, and all the actors were in masks. But not cool theatrical masks. They're doing a naturalistic, contemporary play in the masks we wear to the grocery store. Is this production going to be safer than most because of those masks? Sure. But it is hella not normal. It is apocalyptic. The answer is not to adapt to putting shows on in masks. It's to not need the masks anymore. Or to put on a show where everyone has tentacles. I mean, what would you rather watch? Also, side note for any vaccine literalists who happen to be reading, this tentacle business is entirely a flight of my own fancy. You will not grow a tentacle if you get the vaccine. You might get a sore arm and feel kind of tired for a day or two. I lost my appetite for a little while. People pay money for that kind of side effect. But I'll crochet you a tentacle if it'll convince you to get the vaccine. It might help keep you warm in this wretched winter of discontent while we wait for everyone to get it together. Oh man, as I was reading, I realized that when I wrote this, we didn't even know about Omicron yet. Like, I was this depressed before the next wave of horrors began. Boy. I don't know. I did get out of the winter just a little bit. I went away for Christmas with my family in Virginia, where I got super lucky, and it was 70 degrees on Christmas Day, and that was very good for me. Because the thing about the dip, like the thing is, it gets cold in Virginia like it gets cold in New York, but it doesn't stay cold like it does in New York. So like once it's cold here in the city, it just hangs out here in cold land. You know, it kind of goes up and down and there are colder days and less cold days and more cold days. But like there's not going to be like a surprise, you know, 70 degree winter day in New York City. I mean, you know, maybe with global warming, we'll get there. But I'm not encouraging that idea. Anyway, I did have a small respite and it did help me. But it is cold again here now in New York. So, but at least here's the thing. I don't know. I feel slightly better because now at least more people are in line with me. Like I felt like I was like, am I crazy? Why is everybody acting like this is over? And now nobody's acting like it's over. It is not over. There are lines down every block for the COVID testing tents, and it is not over. That's not good. None of it is good. It's all terrible. But we don't have tentacles, so I guess that's something. Anyway, Happy New Year! Happy negative tests, rapid, and PCR. Woot, woot, woot. Anyway, speaking of the new year, I am wrapping up the making of the zines for my patrons on Patreon. If you would like one, you could become a patron before the end of the year, and I will send you one. It's like you're getting a deal, right? You could do it. Feel free. That place to do that is patreon.com/EmilyRDavis. You can also shoot me some support via PayPal or Ko-fi. All those links are in the show notes. And, also the other thing that you get at the end of the year for patrons, if you're a patron, is I collect all the music from this very podcast and I send it to everybody who is a patron. So at this point, that is the only way to get the songs. Aside from, you know, you could just listen to the podcast and like skip ahead if you want to. But I don't put the stuff up anywhere aside from in the podcast. So if you want it, that's the place to get it. Become a patron. That's all that business. So for a song here today, my first thought was Hazy Shade of Winter. And it is my best thought because I did think about some other stuff, but ultimately it was absolutely too perfect. So, had to do it. And I will play that for you in just a minute. The other songs that I considered, there's a Merle Haggard song, which I had not heard before, about, it's called, I think, If We Can Make It Through December. And it's about, like, December being, like, the heart of winter and how it's going to be better after December. And I was like, I can't do this song because I do not believe for a minute that it's going to be better after December. Because at least, you know, seasonally in New York, the worst part of winter is like January, February. And then March actually is almost worse because you're like, is it over yet? And then it isn't. So, you know, if the song were If I Can Make It Through March, then that would be the right song, but December is only the beginning. I don't know where December is the heart of winter. Do you live in a place where December is the heart of winter? It must be the heart of winter somewhere, right? Like we have different kind of weather patterns. If that's true for you, please tell me about it because I would like to know. Also, there are a lot of songs about winter. I'm intrigued by how many choices I had, but ultimately it's gotta be the Simon and Garfunkel or the Bangles. Also my generational version of Hazy Shade of Winter. This is on guitar. I haven't played my guitar in so long. It was at least a step out of tune when I picked it up. But I tried it on both the ukulele and the guitar was worlds better. Sometimes, the ukulele really is great for so many things, but in this case, the guitar was the clear choice. And it's good for me to pick it back up, poor thing. It wasn't out of tune. It was out of tune. Usually it's like a little, like a little hair out of tune. But this was like, in one case, like a full step and a half flat. Anyway, often my guitar will actually go out of tune. It'll go sharp. But this time it's flat. I think it's because the way the heat works in our apartment is like, either really hot, it becomes like really hot, usually around 4 o'clock in the morning. And then, you know, then it's freezing cold for a few hours and then it's hot again. Anyway, I don't think that's good for string instruments. In fact, I know it isn't. So I suspect that that's what's going on. And since I wasn't playing the guitar, I haven't been helping it out in that flux. Anyway, I will give to you here. This is Hazy Shade of Winter on guitar.
Time, see what's become of me. While I looked around for my possibilities, I was so hard to please. But look around, leaves are brown, and the sky is a hazy shade of winter. Hear the Salvation Army band. Down by the riverside is bound to be a better ride than what you've got planned. Carry your cup in your hand and look around you. Leaves are brown now, and the sky is a hazy shade of winter. Hang on to your hopes, my friend. That's an easy thing to say, but if your hopes should pass away, simply pretend that you can build them again. Look around, the grass is high, the fields are ripe. It's the springtime of my life. Seasons change with the scenery, weaving time in a tapestry. Won't you stop and remember me at any convenient time? Funny how my memory slips while looking over manuscripts of unpublished rhyme. Drinking my vodka and lime. But look around, leaves are brown now, and the sky is a hazy shade of winter. Look around, leaves are brown, there's a patch of snow on the ground. Look around, leaves are brown, there's a patch of snow on the ground. Look around, leaves are brown, there's a patch of